this video, I am going to discuss about the disease hemophilia. Competency for the today's class: explain the symptoms and mode of inheritance of the hemophilia. Firstly, we need to know that there are mainly three types of hemophilia: hemophilia A, hemophilia B, and the hemophilia C. Here, there are different clotting factors are deficient in the blood. In hemophilia A, there is deficiency of factor 8, and in hemophilia B, deficiency of factor 9, and in hemophilia C, deficiency of the factor 11. So we can remember now, but after some time we will start confusing. So what we need to remember, you need to remember only one thing: factor 8 is also called as anti-hemophilic factor A. So you can easily remember factor 8 deficiency in the hemophilia A. Then just add plus 1 and then plus 2. Plus 1 is 9 and then 11 is plus 2. So hemophilia B is there is deficiency of factor 9, and in hemophilia C there is deficiency of the factor 11. Hemophilia A is the second most common bleeding disorder next to the von Willebrand disease. And mode of inheritance: in hemophilia A there is X-linked recessive type of inheritance, and in hemophilia B again X-linked recessive type of inheritance, but in hemophilia C there is autosomal recessive type of inheritance. When you hear the word X-linked recessive, you must know that males are usually getting affected and females always remain as carriers. And in autosomal recessive, both male and females are manifested equally, and it must be a homozygous condition to manifest the disease. Hemophilia A is also called as classic hemophilia, and hemophilia B is also called as Christmas disease, because factor 9 is also called as Christmas factor, right? Okay, now we'll discuss about the symptoms. Symptoms: so as you know, this is the bleeding disorder. So the main symptom will be associated with the excessive bleeding. The most common feature that we will see is hemarthrosis, means bleeding into the joint cavities, and the patient will manifest with the crippling hemarthropathy. I have seen many of the children, usually they will play. While playing, they might get hurt. So whenever there is hurt to the knee, I can see that there will be swelling over the knee joint. This is nothing but a hemarthrosis. Hemorrhage secondary to the trauma or surgery, and there is bleeding persists from days to weeks, and there will be spontaneous bleeding into the cavities, body cavities, and the tissues. And let's look at the treatment part. So if we given the deficiencies, then definitely we can manage the disease. In hemophilia A, we will give factor 8, and in hemophilia B, factor 9, in hemophilia C, factor 11. And we can also give fresh frozen plasma and cryoprecipitate, because they also containing these factors. This was the end of the video. If you have any doubt, please drop down them in the comment box. And thanks for watching video completely.